Well, I got to get this stuff fried and put in the freezer so I can saute. I'm going to saute my vegetables and put them in the freezer so I can use them with, I don't know, mix them with meat or mix them with rice if I have any meat. But I got lots of rice and pasta and sauces. And what I have, I've got a poblano pepper, and I love poblano. And I've got some bell peppers and green, and they're going orange. That means they're sweeter and they're more ripe. And that's why yellow and orange and red peppers tend to be sweeter, is because, and more expensive, because they've been growing longer on the vine. And I got some mushrooms, poblano pepper, and portobello mushrooms. And I've got a yellow, and white onions. I'm going to mix both. And my really favorite thing in the world, too, is this shallot. If you guys haven't ever used a shallot, use it like an onion. They're excellent. And tons of garlic. And in here, I have a mix of, from last summer, I've got rosemary, basil, my all-time favorite, and a sage, I believe it is. But God, it smells good. And I let my herbs dry, and I just keep them in a jar like this, and works good. Okay, I'm going to cut those up and saute them. My goodness, just 1 minute and 47 seconds. Okay, and I guess that's all. I got the views going on in the background, and I don't know. Let's go look out the window before I start. Hold on. Well, the ice is getting really dark, and I guess it gets darker when it gets thin, so it's not as thick. Now, up front here, I don't know if that's thicker. Oh, no, I just wouldn't walk on any of it. And it's going to get warm. Going to get warm. And I guess that's all I have to say for 2 minutes today. Just a shorty. I hope everyone's taking care. And I could start griping about, you know, all the social distancing. They say 6 feet. I want to know who says that 6 feet is appropriate. I mean, I don't trust this thing at all. It's just too rampant. It jumps too quickly. It spreads too fast. And there's a thing, whether it's aerosol or droplets. Aerosols are smaller particles. Aerosols can get on a piece of dust and float how many feet over in the wind? I do not know. I'm sorry. But I just everyone, please take this carefully. You know, we got our walking paths and bike paths and stuff. And it's just congregated with people. Just, you know, all carrying on. And, you know, I guess I'm one of those of stay in the house. Stay away from people. I'm sorry to be so radical. But I guess that is who I am. That's who I am. I had a trip scheduled, the beginning of February. And I was going to go to Arizona. And it was, I canceled that trip because I saw this thing coming and I didn't know how soon it would come, how badly. And I guess I couldn't, I don't think, I didn't go on that trip. But I was aware then. And, you know, people just don't take this seriously enough. I guess we'll be having deaths and overcrowded hospitals, and before people realize that they should keep their distance, big distance. 20 feet is too scary for me. I don't want to see anybody. Okay, take care, everyone. And I'll let you know how my food turns out. I'm sure it will be good. I'm a good cook. All right, bye.